from beautiful downtown Queens, it's Best Time Ever with Neil Patrick Harris. Tonight, watch Britney Spears fall under Neil's spell. It's back, the Coast to Coast Karaoke Competition. Sing along live. Plus a heroic end of the show that'll make you jump for joy.
For one night only, your star guest announcer is me, Alec Baldwin. Now, please welcome the man who puts the hat trick in Neil Patrick Harris, your host, Neil Patrick Harris.
Ever, and we are live. So, if you watched last week, welcome back. If this is your first time checking us out, please fasten your safety belt and keep your hands, arms, and legs inside the train at all times. Last Tuesday night, we were the number one hashtag on Twitter. Boom. And no, I appreciate the feedback. I think at VNS Retrograde summed our show up best with this tweet. WTF is happening. This S is bonkers. Retrograde, you're welcome. This show would not be great without a wonderful guest announcer, and we have one of the best. It's Alec Baldwin! Hey, Alec! Hey, bud. Thank you so much for joining us for our second show.
Well, thanks for having me, Neil. I have to admit, I was a little nervous about it.
Why?
Well, you pushed National Treasure Reese Witherspoon off a building last week.
Well, no, she ziplined down on her own free will. I would never knowingly put anyone in danger. On a totally unrelated note, you allergic to bees?
Yes, why do you ask?
No reason. Kill the beard of bees. See? Look at us. On a live show, you gotta be flexible, which is why we invited your lovely wife, Hilaria, to keep everyone limber backstage. Look at her. Yeah. Work it. Hi, Hilaria. You look amazing. Thanks for being here. Oh, congrats on the baby.
Hello, sweetheart.
Hi, honey.
Don't mix with any of the stage hands. They're like carny folk, not to be trusted. Congratulations, Harris. This is the most bizarre date night we've ever had.
Fair enough. Well, you guys make a beautiful couple, but you're not the only lovebirds here with us tonight. We have lots of amazing people in the crowd. In fact, this young lady is Jackie Harris Greenberg, wife to our writer Paul Greenberg, and you just celebrated a wedding anniversary.
20 years.
20 years.
Yeah.
Congratulations. I love that. Jackie, tell us...
You didn't come to our wedding.
What's your secret?
What's our secret? Always be kind. And it's very hard sometimes.
I get that. Who else is here? Hey, what's your name?
Jamie.
Hi, Jamie. Who are you here with?
My friend Janelle.
Your friend Janelle? Oh, you're single?
No.
You're not? Well, where's your man friend?
He's back home with the dog.
Wait a second. That sound can only mean one thing. It's time for a segment. Come on, let's get ready. Yup, have a seat. I love this. So tell me, what's your name, where you're from?
I'm Jamie, and I'm from Las Vegas.
Las Vegas?
Yeah.
And who is this boyfriend that doesn't want to have the best time ever?
He has to work. He's a busy man.
What's his name?
Curtis.
Curtis. Where is he right now?
In Vegas.
In Vegas. I know he's in Vegas because we have a camera set up in your living room. Here, take a look. Curtis. He's sleeping. That's a buzzkill. Is he always like this?
He works really hard.
He works hard. Is he lazy? Is he not really a spontaneous dude?
You know, he's wonderful.
He's wonderful. I'm not sure I'm believing you. Look at you. You're all dressed up, looking beautiful, appearing with me on national television. See, Curtis needs to be a guy who will do stuff like that with you. Stuff like this.
The shades, the pink jacket, the enormous girth is even sexy on you. You're like a bear meets Fred Astaire. I've never seen anything like it. You're a winner.
Wow.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Is that a moment?
Love it. That's amazing. Did you have any idea he snuck away to do that?
No.
Did you have any idea that he owned that jacket?
No.
Wait, what else do you know about him? He seems fearless. Is there anything he's afraid of? Any phobias?
Snakes, I think.
Snakes? Doesn't like snakes?
Yeah.
It's snakes. Why does it always have to be snakes? If he doesn't like snakes, then why would he do something like this?
Hi, I'm Jay Salmoni from Animal Planet. If I'm here, something extreme and dangerous is about to happen. Curtis? All right, here we go. Now, Curtis, we're about to put a reticulated python around your neck. It's not just an ordinary snake. It can go up to 25 feet and is a deadly predator. Bring in the snake.
What the?
That's a big snake.
Ooh. Holy cow.
There you go. All right, start the clock. Oh. All right. You're right. Okay. How's he feeling?
He's really squeezing.
All right. Get your hand in there around your throat. Get your hand up here. Up here. There you go. There you go. There you go.
Oh, it's starting to tighten up. Yeah. I'm feeling it. It's squeezing.
All right, guys. Let's go. Grab the snake. All right. Okay. Holy crap.
Look at that. I love that. Conquering his fears like some kind of warrior. There's nothing Curtis won't do.
He's incredible.
No, Jamie, there's nothing Curtis won't do. Watch this.
Welcome back to Las Vegas, where stage one of the national finals of American Ninja Warrior are well underway, but we had a competitor no show. We have seen people go from watching the show to competing, but never seen someone walk out of the stands onto the starting block. Who does that?
The man who lives off of being spontaneous.
Look at him. He's still going.
He is not quitting.
He doesn't care. 345 pounds.
Matt, never seen anyone so determined.
Do you believe bears can fly?
He is so relentless, but this guy doesn't seem to have any quit in him. Man, he's still going, Matt. There is no stopping him.
Oh, and splash down.
That is an impressive leap out of the bear.
This bear is continuing to climb.
Holy chump.
Are you kidding me?
Jamie! Your boyfriend, Curtis James, did all of this for you. You may think he's the guy that sleeps on couches all day, but he reached out to us because he wanted to show you what kind of guy he really is. So, actually, let's hear from him right now. Curtis? Curtis, where are you? Where? He's not there.
Oh, my gosh.
Well, that can only mean one thing.
No.
He's gone to the can. I'm kidding. No. No, no, no. Take a look at this. Curtis, I am so impressed by your singing and your snaking and your splashing and the suit. How you feeling?
Tired, really tired, but good.
I bet. Well, now that, you know, you've accomplished all of these things, is there anything you want to say to, you know, show her what a man you are?
Yeah, Jamie, over the last 2 years, we've been on an unbelievable journey.
Oh, my God.
Nobody else I'd rather spend the rest of my life with, and there's one question I need to ask.
Your new name is going to be Jamie James. How cool is that? Well, thanks, Curtis, for reaching out and allowing us to help make your proposal so special. And I think we should make it a little more special. So why don't we send you guys on a romantic trip to Tahiti? That's right. You'll fly on Air Tahiti Nui and spend 5 days at the beautiful Hilton Moorea Lagoon Resort and Spa. What do you think of that, bud?
Oh, Neil, please tell me you aren't going to plant hidden cameras on their honeymoon. That seems like a little much.
Hey, man, whatever's filmed on their honeymoon, that has nothing to do with me. Unless... No? Okay, okay, fine. Alec, throw us to break.
Still to come, Joe Jonas and Neil get all up in Britney Spears' head. We surprise people in their living rooms in a good way. It's Sing Along Live, and these guys get loose at the end of the show. Stick around.
Hey, welcome back to Best Time Ever. Wait a minute. Where'd Alec Baldwin go? Oh.
Sorry. I was just doing some yoga during the break up here, Neil, to stay loose, you know? Wow.
Is there enough room to do yoga up there?
Close it.
Hilaria, wait. Wait a minute. What have you two kids been up to?
Well, we just joined the 20-foot high club.
The 20-foot high club, nice. This show just got sexy. And it's about to get a lot sexier. Please welcome the foxy, funny, fantastic Nicole Scherzinger.
Yes.
So it's our second week. You having fun?
I'm having such a good time. Everybody is so nice here. All the guys in the crew are, they're always telling me good job and giving me super long hugs and offering to help me with my quick changes.
Well, you don't have any quick changes tonight.
But we've been practicing all week. That makes sense now.
As anyone knows, I find nothing more satisfying than besting other celebrities in duels of strength and or wit for little to no reward. Which means it's time for Neil versus.
I don't know what that is.
Nicole, since this is the part of the show I know nothing about, please tell me what's about to happen.
All right. Well, Neil, this week's challenge is BTE News. It's a cold reading teleprompter quiz based on current events.
Okay.
And your challenger this evening is Seth Meyers!
But that's hardly fair. I mean, I love you, Seth, but you've read news on your show for over 30 years.
How old do you think I am?
20.
Oh, God bless you.
Thanks.
I thought I was gonna get to do something cool, like, you know, zip line from one building to another, or propose to somebody, or wear a beard made out of bees.
Oh man, you'd have done that?
Yeah.
Oh.
All right, boys, let's take our way over to the seats
okay.
And get started.
Okay. Who goes where?
Neil, you're to the right of me, and you are to the left of me, Seth.
Oh boy.
And this makes it official.
Oh, very official.
Got a mug. And here are the rules. You will be reading news off the teleprompter, boys. However, certain words will be left out.
Okay.
Fill in the missing word and win a point. Get it right and you'll hear this. Get it wrong and you'll hear this. Understood?
That's very appropriate sounds. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Great.
All right. I will be your moderator, Nicole Scherzinger. And this is the BTE News Primetime versus Spectacular.
All right, thanks, Nicole. The Pope began his 10-day trip to Cuba and the United States over the weekend by arriving in Havana, where he was greeted by President Reagan. It's not Reagan at all.
No.
Who is it?
The correct answer is Raul Castro.
Castro, yeah, I should have gotten that one.
Today, his arrival stateside was accompanied by school students who were singing Sweet Caroline and God Bless America?
No, I'm sorry, Seth. I'm afraid it's Louie.
Well, Louie, random.
I guess I just love America more than those kids.
You should. Seth, reports confirm that GOP candidate Donald Trump will be portrayed in the upcoming season of Saturday Night Live by cast member Taryn Killam.
Well done.
Ooh. Thank you.
Suggest before Game of Thrones actor Peter Dinklage accepted his Emmy for Best Supporting Actor, he spit gum into his wife's hand?
I'm sorry. The correct answer is his wife's mouth.
Well?
No, really?
True story.
That's disturbing.
And I guess he likes germs more than I do.
In award show news that isn't gross, for her portrayal of Crazy Eyes in Orange is the New Black, the Emmy for Best Actress in a Drama went to, I don't remember. Who is it?
Uzo Aduba, not to be confused with the wickedly talented Adele Dazeem.
Nice, interesting.
Aside from Emmy recipients, arguably the biggest win this past Sunday belonged to the star of a viral video, a rat that climbed down a flight of subway stairs holding a piece of pizza. Oh!
I read
the New York Times.
In music news, according to sources close to the Spice Girls, a reunion tour may happen next year with all five members. Their nicknames are Scary Spice, Baby Spice, Sunny Side Spice, Victoria Spice and Shemp Spice.
Almost, Neil. The correct answers that you missed are Sporty Spice, Ginger Spice, and Posh Spice.
Posh, I'm sorry. Who could forget Posh?
Boy, last time the Spice Girls went on tour, I unfortunately wasn't able to get my hands on tickets, and that sent me spiraling through the five stages of grief, which include denial, acceptance, anger, grief, and sub-grief.
Seth, so close. You just missed bargaining and depression.
Okay, well, I'll have those later.
And that's the BTE News. I'm Nicole Scherzinger.
I'm Seth Meyer.
And I'm Neil Patrick Harris. So wait, what was the score?
Amazing job, you two. The final score is Neil 3, Seth 4, which means Seth is the winner.
Seth Meyers, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Unbelievable. Thank you. Seth Meyers, everybody. Catch him later tonight on Late Night by simply not changing the channel. And now, Alec Baldwin with our toss to break.
Thanks, Neil. Still to come, three lucky home audience members will get to be a part of the show in Sing Along Live. The voices in Britney Spears' head sound a lot like Joe Jonas and Neil. And me, Skip Thunderbolt, with the weather. Stick around, we'll be right back.
I don't know. One rep, 450, 475. Oh, hey, welcome back to Best Time Ever. Last week, we surprised people at home with a chance to win money by simply singing karaoke, and we all loved it, so why not do it again? Nicole?
It's time for Sing Along Live.
Yes, sir. Yeah, okay, here is how it works. Through the magic of Skype, we've planted hidden cameras in three viewers' homes somewhere in America, and they have no idea they are about to be part of the show. Let's go to our first unsuspecting singer from Englewood, New Jersey. It's Allison Antwi. How are you, Allison? You got the champagne going, I love it. Get ready. Come to you in a second. Our next singer is in Deerville, Illinois. Get ready because it's you, Andy Kim. Be excited, but not too excited, or you'll wake the baby. Don't wake the baby. And for singer number three, we are going to Fairfield, Connecticut, and Johnny Diaz. Oh, Johnny.
Gangnam Style.
Who's Johnny, we say, and smile. Okay, here we go. We are going to have a live performance here in the studio by a bona fide music superstar. When the song stops, the player whose face is on the screen must complete the lyric. If they do that, they'll win $1,000. Nicole, who is performing for us tonight?
Neil, I love her so hard. Please welcome one of the most identifiable voices in music, International First Lady of Rock, Bonnie Tyler!
I have to ask, what will you be singing for us?
Total Eclipse of the Heart.
Of course you will. I love it. All right, crank the wind machine and set the lights to sexy. It's time to play Sing Along Live!
Coming round.
Turn around.
Every now and then I get a little bit tired of listening to the sound of my tears.
Turn around.
Every now and then I get a little bit nervous. The best of all the years have gone by.
Turn around.
Every now and then I get a little bit terrified. Then I see the look in your eyes.
Turn around.
But every now and then I'm need you more than ever.
No, that wasn't it at all. It was holding on forever. You were close, though. You said a rhyming word, but it's not the right one. We can't give you the $1,000, but we're still having fun, and you look great in your living room. It's on with the sing-along. Congratulations, sir. That's the way you do it. Let's keep the sing-along going. So close. It's all right. We're 1 for 3. We're still having a great time. Congrats to one of you. Meh. It's time for more Bonnie Tyler. Let's hear it.
Coming up, Joe Jonas and Neil help Britney Spears find a new bodyguard. One audience member will get lucky. And it all comes together in the end of the show that you will never forget. I taught her that move. Stick around.
Hey, welcome back to Best Time Ever. You know what's more fun than being a celebrity? Ordering other celebrities around. And that's exactly what I got to do in a new segment we call Voices in Your Head. So, here's how it works. We hide a bunch of cameras somewhere and then find a celebrity willing to do and say whatever I tell them. In this case, it's pop sensation Britney Spears. Oh, yeah. So, her task was to interview bodyguards for her Piece of Me show at Planet Hollywood Resort in Las Vegas. I enlisted my second favorite Jonas brother, Joe, to help out. After Joe and I went through hundreds of applicants anxious to guard Britney's body, we settled on a few courageous guys to have fun with. This is it. Check it out. Hi, Britney. Can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you.
You agree to say everything we tell you to say and do everything we tell you to do?
Yes.
Britney is meeting with 3 bodyguards, Keith Manning, Wesley Patterson, and the first to arrive, Andrew Opel.
Okay, Britney, the first bodyguard is coming your way.
Oh, God.
You're going to say, hi, I'm the one and only Britney Spears, and then hold out your hand and have him kiss it.
One and only Britney Spears.
Andrew, so nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
You're not gonna kiss my hand?
You're not gonna kiss my hand?
Pleasure to meet you.
How strong are you?
How strong are you?
I went strongest in the military back in 2011.
In the whole military?
In the whole military?
Yeah.
Stronger than tanks?
Stronger than tanks?
Not stronger than tanks.
Our second bodyguard, this guy's name is Keith. You're gonna say hi, I'm Britney Bitch.
Hi!
Hello!
It's Britney Bitch. What's your name?
My name's Keith, how you doing?
Come on, come sit down. Just sit there. No, I wanna sit there. No, you sit there.
She's gone rogue.
Come on, Britney.
Your final bodyguard, is this Wesley? So we're gonna say, I'm Britney, look what I can do, and then juggle the water bottles. So I hear I'm supposed to hire you.
Why?
I've worked on the worst of security situations.
So you're like a superhero? Like Batman?
Exactly.
Or Scooby-Doo.
I did a little test for you.
We'll do a little test over here.
I hid something. It's something kind of dangerous. It's understandable. I want you to find it.
I want you to find it.
Go.
Brittany has no idea what's hidden in the seats.
Colder.
Hotter. I'm talking about me.
Oh my God!
Can you be close to me at all times? Without anyone noticing?
Yes.
Even when I'm doing this? Stay close, Keith.
Protect me.
He's holding the cactus. Be inconspicuous.
I'm
here.
Special thanks to Wesley, Andrew, and Keith for being such great sports. You can download Joe's newest single, Cake by the Ocean, with his new group DNCE, and be sure to check out even more of our Day with Brittany tomorrow morning on the Today Show. There's lots we haven't shown you. What's coming up next, Alec?
Still to come, someone's going to get a chance to get lucky and win a mountain of prizes, and it all comes together in the most physically demanding end of the show yet. Stick around.
If I had to, Scarlett Johansson. Oh, hey, welcome back to Best Time Ever. So, who's here tonight wants to get lucky? That is good, because you might get a chance to play for an all-new Jeep Renegade Trailhawk, the official auto of Best Time Ever and the most capable small SUV around. But that's not all. You could also be taking home all of this great stuff furnished by our generous prize providers.
A weekend for two in Las Vegas, $5,000 in cash. The Michael Phelps signature Swim Spa Force by Master Spa. $2,500 from Hotels.com, good at hotels worldwide. TaylorMade golf clubs. Four tickets to see Chicago on Broadway. A Sharper Image massage chair. Karaoke courtesy of the Singing Machine. Premium cookware from Analog. Your very own air bike. A dining room set. A year's supply of breath mints, tube socks, a barnyard of chia animals, and some pretty good ham.
So, these are pictures of our audience members, and now we are going to pick one in 3, 2, 1. Stop! Oh! Tiffany Benson! This is gonna be a real bummer. How are you? Here, you can stand right there behind the mic. No pressure.
Got it.
You look gorgeous.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So these are all the prizes that you are going to be playing for. You just saw them. We're gonna cover them up. We're gonna give them a shuffle. Shaboom. Now, no one knows which prize is where. Here is how this works. I'm going to ask you as many questions as I can from this week's news in 60 seconds. If you get a question right, pick a number, and the prize behind that number is yours.
Okay.
That's all there is to it. Ready?
Got it. Yes.
Good luck, Tiffany.
Thank you.
You have 1 minute starting now. Which comedian said she could kiss Donald Trump for hours? Mindy Kaling or Tina Fey?
Tina Fey.
Incorrect. Earlier in the show, Britney Spears was looking to hire who? A personal assistant or a bodyguard?
Bodyguard.
Correct. Pick a number.
7.
At Sunday's awards, Andy Samberg shared his username and password to what online service? HBO Go or Amazon Prime?
Amazon Prime.
Incorrect. What singer just released a cover album of Taylor Swift's 1989? Adam Levine or Ryan Adams?
Ryan Adams.
Correct. Pick a number.
11.
Multiple advisors pulled out of The View after hosts made jokes about what profession, engineering or nursing?
Nursing.
Correct. Pick a number.
One.
The world was changed this week when Kate Middleton debuted which new hairstyle? A bob or bangs?
Bangs.
Correct. Pick a number.
Six.
Oscar Mayer just debuted a dating app for bacon lovers named what? Fat Love or Sizzle?
Sizzle.
Correct. Pick a number.
Nine.
Nine. What snack just introduced a limited edition of rainbow-colored chips, Doritos or Pringles? I'll let you answer.
Pringles.
Incorrect. It was Doritos. That's all right. You got how many right? Five correct. Well done. You won five prizes. But wait. I want to give you the chance to walk away with all 16 prizes. So I have one more make or break question. You get it wrong, you'll lose all the prizes you already have, but you get them right and you will win them all. So what should she do? Should she stay or play? Alec Baldwin?
Play!
Play.
You want to play? Very good. She's going to play. So. Let's take a look at what you're risking. Let's see what prizes you had already won. The ham. You won the ham and the tickets to Chicago. It's a hot ticket. And Vegas. But now we're going to have a chance to win them all. Okay, I need absolute silence in the studio. Tiffany, I will accept only your first answer. Here is your make or break question. The first recording contract signed by the Beatles. $1,000 or $75,000?
$75,000.
Are you a Beatles fan?
No.
I could tell. But you got it right! You get all 15 prizes! Congrats, Tiffany! Well done. That's amazing. You feeling lucky? Just go to NBC.com/besttimeever and you could be standing here next week and win thousands of dollars just like Tiffany. But for now, it's back to Alec Baldwin!
Still to come, something so spectacular, it can only be called the end of the show show. You stuck around this long, there's no turning it back now. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been my honor and privilege to be your guest announcer this evening. We have already witnessed a heartwarming proposal, a battle of smarts with Seth Meyers, the sweet serenade of Bonnie Tyler, a Britney Spears demanding job interview, and one incredibly lucky studio audience member took home a ton of prizes. But now we turn our attention to the stage for tonight's climactic finale, where the one and only Neil Patrick Harris will put it all on the line in the most daring and death-defying end of the show yet.
of midnight in my wildest fantasy. Somewhere just beyond my reach, there's someone reaching back.
And the one and only Alec Baldwin. We'll be back next week with more stunts, more celebrities, and more chances to get lucky. We'll see y'all next Tuesday at our new time, 8, 7 Central, right here live on NBC. And until next week, it's been the best time ever. Good night, everybody!
On our all-new Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon, Anne Hathaway drops by NBC Tonight.